Our feelings we with difficulty smother.
Culty smother.
When our vegetary duties to be done.
To be done.
I'll take one consideration with another.
With another. A carrot's lot is not a happy one.
Oh!
Wait a minute. Who are these guys?
They're my backup group.
Some works are seemingly timeless, endlessly celebrated for years, decades, centuries. Other works fall into obscurity almost immediately, forgotten and lost. And for a lucky few, there's a cycle between the two, a burst of mainstream popularity, then falling out of favor, only to be rediscovered by a new generation years later. Then, out of the spotlight, back into the spotlight, back and forth, the audience renewing itself. This cycle seems to be the case with one of the core works of Jim Henson, The Muppet Show. With its recent inclusion on the Disney Plus streaming service, it's now on the upswing of its cycle, being reintroduced to the children of today. Children who probably know who the Muppets are, but haven't been able to watch the series that made them into an institution. I know that was the case for me, only it wasn't Disney that introduced the show to me, but Nickelodeon.
Extra, extra! The one and only Muppet Show is now on the only network for you. Critics are raving about Kermit.
He's never been better.
Celebrities are wiggy about Miss Piggy.
Pigs in space! I love pigs in space.
Swedish chefs everywhere are speechless.
It's really good, egg to shit.
It's the one and only Muppet Show, and it's only on Nickelodeon.
I can sum it up in one word. Indescribable.
Don't miss the Muppet Show every weeknight at 7:30, 6:30 Central. Only on Nick.
From April of 1994 to March of 1996, The Muppet Show found a new home on the first network for kids, initially airing both in the morning for the Nick Jr. crowd, and then in the evenings for the post-dinner audience, allowing it to be both something young children could discover anew for themselves, and a family bonding experience as everyone huddled around the TV. Of course, there's a larger video to make about this when Knacks gets to 1994, but for sample platter, let's just take a look at one episode of The Muppet Show and see how it ticks. Our selection today is the Gilda Radner episode. Originally airing in the United Kingdom on April 2nd, 1978, and in the United States on December 14th of the same year, the Gilda Radner episode was the fourth episode of the show's third season, and the 61st episode overall. For the uninitiated, the late Gilda Radner was a comedian and actress known as one of the original Not Ready for Primetime players, the premier cast of Saturday Night Live in 1975, and was still on SNL when she made her appearance here. In fact, the very first scene of this episode is Radner playing one of her SNL characters, Emily Latella, an older lady whose difficulty in hearing results in confusion.
What's all this fuss I keep hearing about me doing the Muffin Show? I mean, what kind of a show is it about muffins? Why, the next thing you know, they'll have me doing a show with rye bread or little tiny lovely biscuits.
Now, Radner was no stranger to the Muppets, as Jim Henson and his creations had been part of SNL's first season with the Land of Gorch segment. While the segments are considered flops, and much of the rest of the crew hated the Muppets, which is fine because Saturday Night Live sucks, the industry knowledge and celebrity connections Jim Henson had gained from that experience had given him the tools he needed to get The Muppet Show off the ground the following year. Radner would be the only SNL cast member to guest on The Muppets. The episode is split in half into two major segments. The first half concerns Radner's performance of selections from The Pirates of Penzance, which Radner turned into a parody, The Parrots of Penzance. Except her note to Kermit the Frog gets misinterpreted.
A 7-foot-tall talking parrot?
Fine, I wrote you in the letter.
Yeah, well, I got your letter, but I couldn't quite read your handwriting. Parrot.
What'd you think I asked for?
Well, I wasn't really sure, but I thought it was a... Never mind.
Must I share my dressing room with the other vegetables?
So it's a joke about misunderstanding another joke, resulting in a scene of a 7-foot carrot and a not-ready-for-primetime player trying and failing to sing I am the very model of a modern major general.
I am the very model of a modern major general. I've information, vegetable, animal, and mineral. I know the kings of England, and I quote the fights of Sarek from Waterloo to Edinburgh.
Hold it, maestro, please. You blew it, my child. Never send a girl in to do a carrot's work. Why don't you just stand back and let me show you how it's done?
I'm the very model of a modern major general. I've information, vegetation, and a maple. Oh, potatoes.
Hold it, hold it. See, you didn't make it either.
Maybe I didn't want to make it.
And as my father used to say, it's a perfectly terrible joke, but it's worthy of us.
That's Brian Henson, son of Jim. And fun fact, Brian Henson built this penguin Muppet for this episode, the very first of many Muppet penguins. The second half of the episode involves a Muppet Lab segment gone wrong, as they are wont to do, with everything in the Muppet Theater getting coated in a quick adhesive superglue. This makes doing the rest of the show quite challenging.
Hi, we're having a little trouble back here, but that's okay, that's okay. Let's just give a great big hand for our very special guest star. Oh no, my hand was stuck. Miss Gilda Radner!
Act 1 and Act 2 are separated not just by plot, but by the type of comedy being used. The first is wordplay and visual absurdity, while the second is pure physical comedy. There's something for everybody! Here's something you might not know about The Muppet Show. As an American-British co-production, it was being produced with both UK and US television in mind. Now, even back in the 70s, American television had way more commercials than British television. Roughly 2 minutes more. Meaning for the UK version of The Muppet Show, a 2 minute extra piece had to be filmed. A short skit or a song. In the case of the Gilda Radner episode, the UK spot has Miss Piggy and other Pig Muppets performing the vaudeville number, The Bird on Nellie's Hat.
Yes, but how about the diamond engagement ring? Of course,
Sid William.
You'll return me that.
Incidentally, the Nickelodeon broadcast of this episode made a few cuts of their own. Gotta cram in that extra little commercial. Most of the stuff they cut were the behind-the-scenes segments, including this gag with Gonzo during all those glue hijinks.
What is Gonzo doing back there?
Oh, he's watching television.
Yeah, well, shouldn't he be further from the screen?
No, his eyes are glued to the set.
The Muppet Show does lend itself to this kind of editing easily. Sketches, musical numbers, and the behind-the-scenes segments fit together like Legos, and can therefore be disassembled and reassembled as needed. And you could argue this modular quality saved The Muppet Show. On the contracting side of things, The Muppet Show licensed a lot of music, without consideration of extensive reruns, and they certainly didn't predict the rise of home media and streaming services. When certain music rights expired, those segments could no longer be aired unless the rights were renegotiated. Because of these music rights, Nickelodeon could only air 65 of the show's 120 episodes. Being broadcast television, there was a limit to how much Nickelodeon could edit out of any given episode. When The Muppet Show started coming out on DVD, the sets had all the episodes, or at least the first three seasons worth before Disney decided the DVDs weren't worth the expense, but multiple episodes on the Season 1 DVDs had segments cut. The Disney Plus release is the most complete The Muppet Show has been since original broadcast, and even they don't have everything. I know, stuff Disney doesn't have the rights to? How novel! There's lots more to discuss here, but that's for a full-length video. As for the Gilda Radner episode, it's perhaps the base average Muppet Show episode. A middle episode of a middle season, after the early season kinks have been worked out, and before the later season experimentation and swinging for the fences happened. The episode is very silly, very charming. There's probably at least one joke in there that'll give you a sensible chuckle. But not much in the way of memorable highlight reel moments. And for the purposes of this channel, not much in the way of important developments for the series. Not at all bad, but not an all-timer. I would call it comfortable. and comfortable is just fine. But for the more interesting, hilarious, and iconic parts of the Muppet Show, you'll just have to wait. This was just a sample.